Dear students, in this video we are going to learn about the movement in snakes. Students, the snakes are vertebrates. They possess a backbone or a vertebral column. It is also known as the spine in their bodies. So they are vertebrates. The snakes are egg-laying animals. They are classified in the group of reptiles. The snakes, they are poisonous ones. There are non-poisonous ones. Many of the poisonous ones we have seen, we know. We know that some of the snakes poison affect the blood vascular system. Some snakes poison affect the nervous system. It is very harmful. So when a snake bites, we want to take the person to hospital very quickly. There are the poisonous snakes such as the crate, the vipers, the cobras. So like that, there are many poisonous snakes are present in our surroundings. Now students, we are going to understand how do the snakes move. The snakes do not have legs, and it is very difficult for us to understand if an animal that do not have legs, then what mechanism in their bodies help them to move. The snakes have a flexible body. They have a vertebral column inside their bodies. This vertebral column is composed of 100 to 400 vertebrae. Each vertebrae connected to the other vertebrae with ball and socket joints. Students, when we studied about the joints in the human body, we studied that the joints present in our vertebral column, in our backbone, they are the gliding joints that allows only little movement to our spine or to our back. But the snake's body, there are ball and socket joints present between the vertebrae. These joints allow maximum movement. The vertebrae are connected to ribs. That means each vertebrae is connected to a pair of ribs. And the ribs are connected to the belly scales. The scales are also known as plates. So the snakes move with the help of scales or plates that are present on the underside of their bodies. Now students, the movement in snakes, that is they do not have legs, but they can move very fastly. A snake's vertebral column, they have a large number of vertebrae. It is connected to ribs, and the ribs are connected to belly scales. Strong muscles attached to the ribs, vertebrae, and the belly scales make the movement possible in a snake's body. So in every vertebrates, we know that there are a system of muscles and bones that work together to encourage the movement of an organism. Movement of a vertebrate organism. Usually the muscles work antagonistically. They work in pairs. When one pair of muscles, if one side of the body, that muscle contracts, the other side, the antagonistic pair will relax. So this constant contraction and relaxation of the muscles that create a wave-like contraction in the body of a snake. Otherwise, we can say that the waves of contraction passing down the body gives the snake an upward thrust. The scales of the body, or the scales, the belly scales present in the body, press down against the ground. When the snake moves, the belly scales are close in contact with the ground. And this pressing of the scales give an upward thrust to the body of the snake. So children, in the snakes, we know that the vertebrae that are connected to each other with the ball and socket joints. Each vertebrae is connected to a pair of ribs. So there are a large number of ribs present in the body of a snake. Then children, the ribs are connected to belly scales. The vertebrae, the belly scales and the ribs are connected to strong muscles. The contraction and relaxation of the muscles make movement of the body possible in a snake. We can otherwise say that the snakes, when they move, the ribs act like legs and the scales act like feet. So, though there are no legs present at the surface of the body, but a leg and feet mechanism is present in the snakes, we can say that the ribs act like legs and the belly scales act like feet. So the snakes can move very fastly on the ground. So students, I hope you understood the mechanism of movement in vertebrates such as snakes. Thank you.